Shalom, Yashallah, Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Hakwadash Rakar, Barakatham. Today's topic, just going in on these harlot houses called churches today, in the land of Babylon. And what I want to do is go into how, we'll go into their 501c3 tax exemption charter they have. I have a few things written down here that I got from the website irs.gov, from their section titled Tax Information for Churches and Religious Organizations, right? Because to be in all honesty, the church as you know today, no matter what the denomination is, no matter what the religion is, their true alliance is not unto who they call God. It's actually to the government, okay? And upon reading certain excerpts from this website, I hope to shed light on that truth. That these are indeed harlot houses that people are spending their time in, giving their money to, and learning from. Okay? And we're going to go into the scriptures, Yahweh Ratzah, and see what the Lord has to say about the doctrine of men and putting aside his word for the traditions of men. Okay, so without further ado, let's jump into it. Exemption requirements. 501c3 organizations to be tax exempt under section 501c3 of the Internal Revenue Code: an organization must be organized and operated exclusively for exempt purposes set forth in section 501c3. In addition, it may not be an action organization. Okay? Now, I went into that action organization term, and it goes into political and lobbying activities. Okay? The churches, as we know it today, are prohibited from political and lobbying activities. Okay? This includes any involvement of any kind in political campaigns, inciting the public concerning legislation, okay? And failure to abide by these requirements results in loss of tax-exempt status. Now, I want to focus in on this point, how they are prohibited for inciting the public concerning legislation, okay, i.e. same-sex marriage. Now, regardless of what the world may say, the God of the Bible, the God of the Israelites, okay, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is a power that is sorely against sodomy, man. Okay, and here in Babylon the Great, this is a land of sodomy, okay? In the scriptures, it is known as a spiritual Sodom in Egypt, okay? So, with homosexuality being an abomination in the sight of Yahweh, why aren't these churches defending the gospel and bringing up the precepts concerning homosexual activity? Okay, why? It's because they are prohibited from speaking out against any political group, against any laws being passed, okay? Because if they do, their tax-exempt status is going to be taken from them, okay? 501c3 organizations are considered charitable organizations and are allowed to receive tax deductible contributions. In accordance to section code 170, churches have to report contributions over $75. Okay? And from the so-called Negro to the so-called Native Indian of North, Central, and South America, all the way down to the Latino. Okay? You know church. You know the whole process of them doing tithes and offerings and their services. Okay? Now, why is that? It's not... Well, it is according to the law, but these churches say that the law is done away with. Okay? So if the law is done away with, why would they push the tithing aspect of the law? Okay? In the scriptures, when you tithe, the tithes belong to the Levites, man, the Levitical priesthood. Okay? And the reason why we pay tithes to the Levitical priesthood, the Levites, is because they had no inheritance when the inheritance was being dished out from the Heavenly Father, okay, by the hand of Moses, okay? The Levites' inheritance was to be joined unto the Heavenly Father, okay? They stayed in the suburbs of their brothers' lands, and their brethren took care of them by giving them gold, silver, cattle, spices, things of that nature. And what the priests would do, they will take the contributions from their brethren or the community, so to speak, and they put it in a storehouse, okay, so to speak, so they could provide for widows and fatherless children and themselves, man. But what does the church do today? They pass the buckets around, okay, and that money goes directly into the pastor's pocket. Okay, you see your pastor pop up with new vehicles, him and his wife, his children, new houses, and they play the biggest hustle of all, the Vision Fund. Okay, the fund that they have to collect to buy a new building for the Heavenly Father. Okay. That is a hustle, okay? Because if you're going to push the tithing aspect of the law, you have to push other tenets of the law dealing with the Heavenly Father, man. Okay, but your churches do not do that because you are harlot houses. So let's go into the scriptures right now. First script I'm going to pull is the prophet Isaiah chapter 29, verse 13. And it says, wherefore the Lord said, for as much as his people draw near me with their mouth and with their lips do honor me, but have removed their heart from me, and their fear towards me is taught by the precept of men. Okay? Because in these churches, they do the song and dance. Okay? They put on the act of them being holy, of them being followers of the Heavenly Father and his only begotten Son. Okay, what they do is masquerade. Salakia. What they do is masquerade as children of the Lord, as servants of the Lord, when really they're only servants of the United States government by way of their 501c3 charter. Because they only push, not only are they pushing the doctrine of the Nicene Creed, they are also pushing the tenets of the United States government, because every church that is established in the land of Babylon, okay, is set up by the federal government, okay? The church true alliance is to the United States government, not Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, okay? This is St. Mark, chapter 7, beginning at verse 7. And it reads, howbeit in vain do they worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men, for laying aside the commandment of the Most High, ye hold the traditions of men, as the washing of pots and cups, and many other such like things ye do. And he said unto them, full well ye reject the commandment of Yahweh, that ye may keep your own tradition. And the tradition that is played out in these churches, the whole message of loving everyone, okay? The Lord loves everyone. The Lord is giving salvation to everyone, okay? Is of is doctrine of men, okay? That is not the doctrine of the Heavenly Father. The Heavenly Father tells you to repent and turn from your backsliding ways. The church pats you on your behind and makes you feel good about your backsliding ways, so you can come back the following week to give more tithes and offerings to this wolf in sheep's clothing, so he could send you about your way, having a false sense of hope to come back the following week to do it all over again, man. Okay? These churches are not teaching you repentance. These churches are not teaching you how to please the Heavenly Father. And these churches are damn sure not teaching the law of the Heavenly Father. Okay? So to the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American male of North, Central, and South America. Okay? And those of you scattered abroad, the four corners of the earth, who descend from those men, because you are truly the children of Israel. You need to get up out these harlot houses, okay? Because they are teaching you rebellion against the Heavenly Father, man. And this generation in these churches are really the ones who gave up our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, man, to be put to death over 2,000 years ago, okay? And you being in these churches, you are in alliance with not only the Satan, but his children, okay? I hope this video was edifying and an eye-opener to the hopeful elect. Peace and salutations to the hopeful elect. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Greatmillstone. Shalom.